What's going on, guys? I have a review for you today. Today I'm going to be reviewing the infamous Hobbit Tweed. So I just now posted a video of me opening that package that I just got today. I might post this tomorrow. I'm filming it today. It's Monday. Might post it tomorrow. Don't know. But Holy Smoking Pipe Padre asked me to do a review on it, so that's what I'm doing. And hopefully I can shed some light on this very, very known blend by the YouTube Pipe Smokers News. First of all, let me give you a description on the Tewksbury website. It says, our almost legendary full-flavored blend starts with fire-cured dark and golden Cavendish. Okay. Well, the blend right here, as you can see, which I'm giving it everywhere, it's mostly dark Cavendish. There is some golden Cavendish right there, as you can see, but yeah. Let me keep on going with this blend, or the review, on the website here. It says, then we added a thread of mild cherry. That's what I smell, mostly inside of this. It, has a similar smell to the Boswell's, cherry smash, but it's a little bit lighter. It's, it has that Boswell's cherry smash, smell to it. That cherry, that kind of like maraschino cherry smell to it. And then it says also on here on the website, and a dash of vanilla with a semi-sweet, pleasant, or of vanilla, okay. I don't smell a lot of vanilla. When I think of vanilla, I go back to the experience of vanilla. Vanilla flake. That's basically when I smell a vanilla tobacco, I always go back to the McBaren's vanilla flake smell. It doesn't really have that kind of smell to it. Yeah, I should probably take that out. It doesn't have that kind of smell to it, but the predominant smell is cherry. But like I said, a lighter cherry. It's not too you know, strong as a full cherry blend, which they say there has a mild, mild cherry flavoring. So let's pack it up here inside of the 7LE 320 Trevi. It's a ribbon cut. It's not moist, and it's not dry. It's like the perfect, perfect consistency for a tobacco. There you go. Got a little inside of the bowl there. As you can see, you got the golden Cavendish and the dark Cavendish coming out there. Don't you hate it when you leave your lighters out and there's a small flame on it? Seems like when you warm it up, the flame gets higher. You know what I need? I need Zippo. I'll have to go out and get one. If I can find some extra money. Anyways, let's light it up here. The first lighting impression is it's not too, it's very subtle. It's not a very like pop in your face. You get the cherry, coming out of it. It's predominantly cherry. I mean, it says that there's a little bit of vanilla in it. I don't taste the vanilla. Unless the vanilla is kind of going down the cherry flavor. When you think of cherry and vanilla, you kind of get like a... When you want a cherry and vanilla, you kind of get like a smooth, kind of like a smoother tobacco. This tobacco is very... It's semi-light because of how subtle the cherry and vanilla is, or are. It's not, like I said, it's not like boom, like in your face. It's subtly sweet. It's subtle. It's not in your face, pow. Which is, sometimes you want that in your face, like sugary tobacco, which I get with some tobaccos that I really like and really enjoy. But this is kind of nice. It's kind of, you know, after dinner smoke and, just chilling, having a drink, and, you know what would go good with this? A nice cream soda. I think that would, complement this really well. I do enjoy having cream soda with, a pipe, especially a vanilla or a cherry blend. It's not bad. I like it. You know, the first time I tried it was about a year ago, and when I tried it, I thought, you know, it was really great, because I haven't tried, I wasn't too experienced with tobacco back then, so I was like, wow, this is really good. And now that I've, you know, been around the block a couple times with tobacco, it's subtle, it's not, you know, like a huge cherry vanilla blend, but it's subtly cherry, not a whole bunch of vanilla, and it's light. I've had a couple bowls before this, and what I do like is there's no bite at all. It's very, very smooth, and it's lovely on the palate. It doesn't burn it. It kind of has like a velvety texture. It doesn't make your mouth dry. Like some tobaccos do. Overall, it's pretty good. Scale of 1 to 5, I give it a 4. It's pretty good. It definitely is more of a cherry than a vanilla, in my opinion. No bite at all. I love it. It's wonderful. Anyways, guys, wow, 9-minute review. Anyways, hope everybody's doing well. Thank you, Smoking Pipe Padre, for telling me to make a video. I got on it. You know what? Oh, it's 9:18 right now. That was kind of weird. It was 9:18 when I looked at the clock on the video. Anyways, it's 9:18, and I think I'll wait till tomorrow to post it so more people will see it, because most people would probably go to bed right now. Anyways, guys, I hope you're having a great day. Hope you had a fantastic weekend. I know I did. And, yeah. See you guys later.